Hello everyone, let's get started with the next session on transmission and distribution underground cables. So the learning objectives of this particular session is we will be able to solve some of the problems in order to find the insulation resistance, stress, sheath radius and all that. In the previous session we had discussed about grading of cables, capacitance of single core cable, dielectric loss, and some of one problem in order to find the insulation resistance. So in this particular session, let's start with solving some of the problems in finding the insulation resistance and many more. The first problem over here is you will be able to solve the insulation resistance from the expression that we have derived on insulation resistance. Okay, so the question says, you are supposed to calculate the insulation resistance of a single core cable of length 6 kilometers with radius of conductor 10 mm, insulation thickness 8 mm, and specific resistance of insulation is 5 into 10 power 12 ohm meters. So let's note down the given data. The specific resistance of insulation is given as rho 5 into 10 power 12 ohm meters. Length of the cable L is equal to 6 kilometers, which is nothing but 6,000 meters. Core radius R is 10 mm. That's given in the problem. Intersheath radius is R2 because it's a core plus the next radius. As a result, it is 10 plus 8. So you have a radius of conductor as 10 mm along with the insulation thickness of 8. So intersheath is the addition of this. As a result, it is 10 plus 8, which is nothing but 18 mm. So later, ln R2 by R1, you get a value of 0.5877. So the insulation resistance expression, as we all know, that it is Ri is equal to rho divided by 2 pi L ln R2 by R1. So on substitution, the insulation resistance value will be this. So you are substituting the value of rho 2 pi, the length value is also substituted along with the value of ln R2 by R1. So the insulation resistance of a single core cable is around 77.94 mega ohms. So let's move on to the next problem. So in this problem, you are supposed to find out the resistivity of the dielectric material, which has a core diameter of 2 centimeters and a sheath diameter of 4 centimeters. For a particular length of 4000 meters, you're supposed to consider the insulation resistance as 2000 mega ohms. For a length of 4000 meters of cable, you're supposed to consider the insulation resistance as 2000 mega ohms. So the core radius R1 over here is nothing but 2 by 2, which is nothing but 1 centimeters. The sheath radius is again 4 divided by 2, which is nothing but 2 centimeters. The value of ln R2 by R1 is nothing but ln 2 by 1, 0.6931. What is the value of resistivity now? The value of resistivity is rho, which is equal to Ri into 2 pi L divided by ln R2 by R1. From the insulation resistance expression itself, this is obtained. So on substitution, substituting the values of insulation resistance, length, along with ln R2 by R1, you will get a rho value as 72.52 into 10 power 12 ohm meters. So the next problem. So in this problem, the problem is, a single core cable for use on a three phase 11 kV 50 hertz system has a conductor area of 0.785 centimeter square. So to continue, you're supposed to find out the maximum electrostatic stress, Gmax. The expression that is used for to find out the value of Gmax is V divided by R1 ln R2 by R1. So this value over here will be 8.981 kV divided by the value of R1 and substitute the value of R2 and R1. On substituting this value, this expression can be later simplified as, and you'll get a value for maximum stress as 16.32 kV per centimeter. The minimum electrostatic stress, G minimum, is nothing but V divided by R2 ln R2 by R1. Again, substituting the value of V, R2, R2 by R1, you will get an expression for minimum electrostatic stress as 5.44 kilovolt per centimeters. On substituting the values over here and later simplifying all this, you will get a value of this as 5.44 kV per centimeter. The capacitance of the cable per kilometer length is not, as asked in the problem, you will get C is equal to 0.024 epsilon R divided by log to base 10 R2 by R1 microfarads per kilometer. On substituting this value of epsilon R, you will get a value of this as 0.2 microfarads per kilometer. Till then, this is the value. It is 0.0960 divided by 0.4779 into 10 power minus 6. So this is the value. 0.024 into 4 divided by log to base 10, 0.015, and substituting the value of R1. On still further simplifying this, you will get a value of capacitance as 0.2 microfarads per kilometer. Next, you're supposed to find out the charging current for this per phase per length of the cable. So IC value is nothing but 2 pi f C Vp. Again, on substituting this value, frequency is 50, C is 0.2 into 10 power minus 6 into the phase voltage. You'll get a value of charging current per phase as 0.399 amperes per kilometer. The most economical conductor size is given by R1 is equal to R2 divided by 2.718. As we have derived this expression in the previous session. The value of R1 will later correspond to 0.55 centimeter. Okay. So on this, on further simplifying, you can also calculate the value of R1 using the other expression. Let's move on to the next problem. So in this problem, the given data is 11 kV 3-phase 50 hertz underground line, 5 kilometer long line, uses three single core cables. Each cable over here has a dia of 3 cm and the radial thickness of insulation is 0.8 cm. The permittivity of the dielectric is 3.5. You're supposed to determine the stress and the total charging kVAr of the cable. You're supposed to determine the stress and the total charging kVAr. Okay, so this is the diagram, pictorial representation, you know, to find out the values. So this is considered as thickness T, this is thickness T, and this is D. So the value of D1 will be the addition of these values. And the core radius is R, intersheath is R1. So let's get started with the problem. The system peak voltage per phase can be calculated as Vp is nothing but 11 kV divided by root 3 into root 2. So we'll get a value of this as 8981 volts. So if you refer to the figure, the inner diameter of the sheath, it's nothing but D1 is equal to D plus 2 times the radial thickness of insulation. This can further get reduced to 3 plus 2 into 0.8, 4.6 centimeter. The value of D1 will be later equal to 0.046 meters. The value of R1, thereby, it's nothing but diameter by 2. So the value of R1 is also as, this can be simplified as 0.023 meters. What is the value of maximum electrostatic stress, Gmax? V divided by small r ln R1 by R. So value of V is substituted small r and capital R1 values is also substituted on simplification. So this value will correspond to 1401092 volts per meter. This is the value of maximum stress. Can later be simplified as 14.01 kilovolt per centimeter. So this is the value of maximum electrostatic stress. Okay, to find out the total charging kVAr, we require the value of capacitance of the cable. So this capacitance of the cable expression, we have solved the problem, derived the expression also. So this is the capacitance of the cable expression. On substituting this value, 0.024 epsilon r divided by log to base 10 r1 by r, you will get a value of capacitance of cable as 0.452 microfarads per kilometer. The total capacitance is nothing but you have to multiply the whatever the value of capacitance that you've got into the length of the cable. So later you will get a total capacitance value as 2.26 microfarads. Charging current of the cable is nothing but IC is 2 pi FCVP. So the value of this is nothing but 4.51 amperes. What is the value of total charging kVA? It's nothing but root 3 VL IC into 10 power minus 3. On substituting these values, you will get a value of total charging kVA as 85.927 kVAr. So this will be the final value of total charging kVAr. Okay. So maximum electrostatic stress, as solved in the previous problem, is nothing but you will be substituting the values of V, small r and R1. On simplification, you will get a value of 64.07 kV per centimeter. That would be the value for maximum electrostatic stress. The total capacitance of the cable, as again, it's just the same as the previous problem. It has to be, this expression is for per kilometer, but you're supposed to consider 4 kilometer long line. As a result, whatever you get for 1 kilometer has to be multiplied by 4. On multiplying, you will get a value for capacitance as 1.97 microfarads. Charging current of the cable is also asked. So it's again, the expression for charging current of the cable is 2 pi FCVP. So you're supposed to substitute the value of VP over here. On substituting the value of F, C and VP, you will get a charging current of cable over here as 16.675 amperes. What is total charging kVAr? It's again root 3 VL IC into 10 power minus 3. So you're supposed to substitute the value of root 3. So substitute the value of VL IC. VL is nothing but 33 into 10 power 3. IC value is 16.675 into 10 power minus 3. KVAr as 953.10 kVAr. Okay. So let's move on to the next problem. So this problem, you're supposed to calculate the radial thickness of the insulating materials and the working voltage of the cable. So here a single core lead covered cable has a conductor diameter of 3 centimeters with insulation diameter of 8.5 centimeters. The cable is insulated with 2 dielectrics with permittivity values of 5 and 3 respectively. The maximum stress in the 2 dielectrics is 38 kV per centimeter and 26 kilovolt per centimeter. So you're supposed to calculate the radial thickness of insulating materials and the working voltage of the cable. The maximum permissible stress is nothing but 38 kilovolt per centimeter, and the maximum permissible stress, 2 values are given over here. So it is in 2 dielectrics, it is 26 kV per centimeter. So Gmax 1 is 38 kV per centimeter and Gmax 2 is 26 kV per centimeter. The radius of the insulation of dielectric, let us consider it as R1 centimeter. And the insulation of inner dielectric, let us consider it as as already mentioned, R1 centimeter. So now you will be using the values of Gmax 1 by Gmax 2. So Gmax 1 is nothing but Q divided by 2 pi epsilon naught epsilon 1 R divided by Q divided by 2 pi epsilon naught epsilon 2 R1. So R is epsilon 1 and R is corresponding to Gmax 1. Epsilon 2 and R1, capital R1, is corresponding to Gmax 2. On simplifying these values, you will get a value of 0.4 R1. On further simplification, the value of radius R1 is nothing but 3.65 centimeter, and the value of D1 is 7.3 centimeters. So radial thickness of the inner dielectric P, the diagram that we have used in our previous problems, so it's nothing but D1 minus D divided by 2. The value of D1 is nothing but 7.3, small d is 3, divided by 2. So the radial thickness of the inner dielectric will be 2.15 centimeters. So the radial thickness of outer dielectric is 8.5 minus 7.3 divided by 2, which is nothing but 0.6 centimeters. So using this expression of V, Gmax 1 small r ln R1 by R plus Gmax 2 capital R1 ln R2 by R1, you will get a value of V as 65.127 kilovolt, and this value is the value of voltage, is the peak voltage. This value is a peak voltage, and it is, you can also, so what is this RMS working voltage? You can also calculate the RMS working voltage, because that is asked in the problem. So in the problem, they have asked you to find out the radial thickness of the insulating material, that is T, small t, and also the working voltage of the cable. So working voltage of the cable is nothing but the RMS value. So once you get to know the value of V peak, you can easily calculate it, calculate the value of VRMS as Vm by root 2 or V peak by root 2. So the peak value over here is 65.127 kilovolts divided by root 2, which is nothing but 46.05 kV. So this is the value for RMS working voltage. Okay. So in this session, we have solved some of the problems in order to solve insulation resistance, maximum stress, minimum stress, working voltage of the cable. You have also calculated the thickness of the inner sheath, outer sheath, and the radial thickness of the insulating materials. So all these problems are important considering the examinations. Okay, thank you.